This sequence explains the method for installing Groundforce's modular hydraulic megabrace, used for supporting large, heavy-loaded, square, rectangular, or irregular excavations. Assembly of the frame commences by first using a certified lifting chain to move and lay each component onto the ground or adjacent hard standing. It's advisable that timber bearers are used to help with the assembly of the frame. Leg components are joined together by interlinking the male and female splice blades and are secured in place with two heavy-duty shear pins and R-clips. Once pins are secure, four transit bolts are used at each joint to avoid straining the blades during lifting and installation. The assembly procedure should then be repeated for any subsequent legs. Megabrace is generally used in conjunction with pre-driven sheets and piles. Using a certified lifting chain, attach the hook to red-painted lifting eyes and lower the individual legs into the base of the excavation onto level timber bearers. A motorized shoring pump is used to expand and retract the hydraulic leg. Expand each leg to form a frame by connecting the quick-release couplers from the hydraulic leg to the motorized shoring pump. The safety lock-off valve is then opened by turning it anti-clockwise using the tool provided. This will allow fluid to flow freely when the pump is operated. With the pump running, move the flow lever to the ram out position. Referring to the technical drawing, adjust the overall length until the pin holes align with the other leg. Connect the legs using the corner pin provided and repeat this process for the other subsequent legs. Once complete, close the lock-off valve on the hydraulic unit and return the lever on the pump to the vertical position to depressurize and remove the hoses. Repeat for all four corners. With the frame now complete, reconnect the hoses to each leg in turn and pressurize to 1000 psi. Attach the hanging chains provided between the frame and the sheet tops at the locations specified in the scheme-specific drawings, at no more than 3 meter centers. This process can then be repeated for any subsequent levels of framing. Once the final frame has been installed, continue to dig to formation level. It's good practice to blind the base with at least 50 millimeters of concrete as soon as possible. Subsequent edge protection and suitable access should be placed as soon as possible to provide a safe working environment in and around the trench, within which to construct the permanent works. Once permanent works have been completed, compaction up to the underside of the lower frame takes place. The lifting chains and hoses are reattached and lock-off valves are opened to depressurize the frame. The frame can be broken apart into manageable lengths and lifted out. Backfill and compaction to the underside of the top frame. Where the process is repeated and each leg of the frame extracted separately. Reinstatement can then continue to ground level. All equipment should then be disassembled, cleaned and stacked, ready for reuse or collection. This video is to be viewed in conjunction with a detailed written user guide, which is available to download from our technical library found on our website.